Hindi rin effective yung magpupuyat ka tapos babawiin mo siya kinabukasan na kung saan matutulog ka kung ilang oras yung hindi mo na itulog nung gabi. According to research, it's not even working. Next is number 6, emotional well-being of a person. It also affects our growth and development. So, children must be nurtured with love, patience, and understanding. So, they need supportive family and environment. So, as you notice, tingnan niyo yung mga bata na kulang sa aruga ng parent, even the parent is providing them with food and the toys that they want. There is a tendency that they will have emotional or mood swings that may affect their physical activities, social activities, that and in the end, there is an effect on their growth and development. So, last part is parenting. So, we are going to talk about parenting styles. Parenting is a practice or an action. It is going out of one's way to assist, help, listen, and do something for a child. So, even you are just the fostering parent or the guardian of a child, the action that you are making in assisting or helping them is what we call parenting. So, we have here Diana Bonglin. So, in 1996, she has distinguished 4 styles of parenting in terms of differences in parental responsiveness and demandingness. When we say responsiveness, it refers to how sensitive, supportive, and involved parents are. And when we say demandingness, Bonglin characterized this as the degree to which parents hold high expectations for their children's behavior and supervise their activities. So let us go to the 4 parenting styles of Bonglin in 1996. The first one is the authoritative parenting. So this is the style of parenting that stresses self-reliance and independence. Parents maintain open communication lines with children and give reasons when instilling discipline. Ito yung nare-recommend ko sa mga parents na i-exercise nila within their family. Next is authoritarian parenting. So, this is a style of parenting that stresses obedience, respect for authority, and traditional values. So, ito yung mas makalumang paraan. Ito yung mga naabutan pa ng ating mga lola at lolo, nanay at tatay. Next is indulgent parenting. This is a style of parenting characterized by show of affection, love, warmth, and nurturance but with little supervision. Next is neglectful parenting. This is a style of parenting characterized by little warmth, nurturing, and supervision. So, I have here a table that will show you the summary or what will be the characteristic of each parenting styles, including their resulting social behavior in a child. The first one is authoritative characteristics. Again, we have demanding, encourages independence, responsive, warm, and nurturing disciplines with explanation, and they always maintain open dialogue with both parents and the children. Next is the resulting social behavior in a child. So, social competence and responsibility is being developed. In authoritative parenting style, hindi lang basta si parent ay magsaset ng expectation sa anak, no? Kundi ay ibibigay niya rin syempre ano yung pangailangan ng bata. So, sila yung mga super supportive parent, no? Now, kapag naman nagkaroon ng achievement yung anak nila, of course, they will praise them, and they will also motivate their child to do more or better. At pag nagkaroon naman ng pagkakamali yung anak nila, of course, nandun yung bibigyan sila ng sanction. And then, ipapaliwanag din kung saan sila nagkamali. Okay? At para the next time na ma-encounter nila yung ganong situation, maiwasan na rin ang bata kung alin yung mga bagay na hindi niya dapat gawin. Maiwasan na rin yung mga pagkakamali. So that is why yung bata, nabibuild sa kanya yung social competence. Kaya niyang mag-stand alone. Siya ay magiging independent. At siya rin ay magiging responsable sa mga actions na gagawin niya. Kasi alam niya yung mga consequences na mangyayari. Kasi naipaliwanag sa kanya ng maigi ng kanyang parent. The second one is authoritarian. So characteristics, demanding, consistent in enforcing standards. This is ito yung actions na ginagawa ng parent, restrictive, and they are controlling. So, ito yung mga parent na masyadong strict to the rules, no? Ito yung kailangan masunod pag sinabi ng parent, gawin to, gagawin to. Sa authoritative parenting styles kasi, si bata ay hinahayaan ng magulang na makipag-bargain ng condition sa parent. So, si parent at si bata magmi-meet halfway kung saan sila mag-aagree sa isang bagay, no? Pero dito sa authoritarian, basta pag sinabi ng magulang, sa yun ang dapat masunod. So, parang dictatorship ang meron dito. Okay? So, what will be the resulting social behavior in child? There will be ineffective social interactions at si bata ay magiging inactive. So more commonly sila yung susunod na lang sa ibang tao, they feel they are inferior to them at they cannot stand on their own. They always wait for a cue or signal or command sa ibang tao before they work on their own. Next is the indulgent parenting. They are responsive. Kung ano yung mga kailangan or gusto ng anak, bigay agad. They are warm and nurturing, but they are undemanding. They are not setting expectation to their children. They use punishment inconsistently and infrequently. Minsan, pag nagkamali si bata, bigyan ng punishment. Pero minsan, nagkamali si bata, hinahayaan na lang din. Hindi nila nabibigyan ng punishment. So, sa part na yun, they are inconsistent. So, they exercise little control. So, ito yung mga parents na parang yung nakikita natin sa movie na sila yung medyo may kaya, mayaman, si parent ay lagi nagtatrabaho, halos wala ng time na rin sa anak nila. Pero, they try as much as possible to give what the student needs or the child needs. Next, the resulting social behavior in this parenting style, the child will have social competence. Of course, marami siyang toy, marami siyang pera, marami siyang pagkain. So, kaya niya magkaroon agad ng circle of friends. Okay? So, the child is also well-adjusted, peer-oriented, at dahil doon, nagkakaroon ng miskanda kasi nga kung sino-sino mga kung sino-sino friends yung nakakahalubilo niya, syempre, magkakaiba sila na ng attitude, behavior na pwedeng makuha ng batang na-raise under indulgent parenting style. The last one is neglectful. So, characteristics, unresponsive, little warm or nurturance, undemanding, sets few limits, and provides little supervision. So, ito yung mga magulang na halos napapabayaan na talaga yung kanilang mga anak. So, resulting social behavior in child. So, there will be poor orientation to work and school kasi nga nasanay sila ng walang nag-guide sa kanila, no? Next, there will be behavior problems. Of course, walang nagmamonitor sa batang to. So, pwede rin magkaroon siya ng iba't ibang klase ng friends na magkakaiba ang behavior na pwede niya ring makuha yun. Or sa environment niya, sa mga napapanood niya sa TV, mga violence, hindi siya nagagabayan towards that. So, yun yung mga pwedeng mangyari sa bata na na-raise under neglectful parenting styles. So, I have here a simple figure representing the relationship among the four parenting styles together with the responsiveness and demandingness criteria. Okay, so I on the second column, we have supportive. Parent is accepting and child-centered. And unsupportive, parent is rejecting and parent-centered. Under demanding, parent expects much of child, and under undemanding, parent expects little of child. So this four parenting styles is color-coded. As you can notice, authoritative is color green because this is highly recommended that we should practice this in our home. And the red one, the uninvolved or neglectful, is not recommended. Hindi natin siya dapat i-practice sa ating pamamahal. Okay? We have here permissive. Permissive is similar with indulgent parenting styles. Now, why do we need to include this in our discussion or in our lesson? Remember, we will be teachers soon. So, in our four corners of the room, we will have so many children with different family background, with different friends, with different perspective, talents, interests. So they have their individuality, individual differences. So as we allow them to stay in our classroom, we must practice a good parenting style because we are the second parent, diba? So tayo yung mag-raise din ng tamang social behavior sa bata. Remember, na-discuss ko dito yung resulting social behavior. So, alin ba dun yung magandang resulting social behavior? Okay? Of course, hindi naman pwedeng laging authoritative tayo. Okay? Again, this is highly recommended. Pero in times na hindi na applicable sa bata yung pagiging authoritative natin, pwede rin natin mag-insist tayo ng pwedeng authoritarian parenting kung saan pwede tayong mag-take in control kapag si bata ay hindi naman applicable sa authoritative. Again, it depends on the situation at sino makakakita nun. Kayo pa rin, si teacher pa rin. Okay, that is why ito ay diniscuss tong apat na to para makita natin ano kaya yung mga pwedeng practicein or pwedeng pagpilian natin. So, okay. So, this is the end of our lesson. I hope you learned something this time. And I would like to thank you for listening and watching in this video presentation. But do not forget to hit like and subscribe for you to get updates for my upcoming videos.